Hello,
I'm C2 Luis Noguera Serrano, president of the European Bulgarian Society, and we are here at Home Dojo, Spain. And today, due to the several emails that we are receiving in our headquarters regarding what it's the Onigumo, mainly from former students from Ogawa Sensei School, some of them are asking about a course that was taught in 1992 about the Yabu line Onigumo. These Yabu line were specific forms of this Onigumo, this violent way of combat, of close combat. And mainly the teachers explain, and in this by what has been led to me, explained to me by Shido Jolan, because I wasn't there, that in this course the Yabu line were divided, the Onigumo, in three different forms that were named as Ushiro, Mai, and Yoko. It means that by the backwards, frontwards, and sidewards. Then in this video the idea is to show you some basic to solve the doubts that you are presenting to us, to solve several doubts or several to make and perform several sequences that could cover the idea for this kata, for these forms explained on Onigumo. Then for explaining, I have here on my left sensei Rebecca Roca preparing for C2 too, and I will use her for explaining these techniques that could be also applied in several circumstances. Starting from the Seiza position, that it will be in the base moment for or the base position to start these techniques, we will cover the following ideas. The first one that we will cover here, it will be to push her in this position, and right now with a very quick movement I will enter with my right leg crossing to the other side by this way, please, from here. What I will do is to, I will open the hakama here to cross for having this position here, this control, and from here have this strong control at this point. If we are here, of course, we could stab and thrust with a small blade into the internal side of the knee and the anterior part of the femoral area, and stabbing and thrusting in this point. But of course, she could react. If we are talking about a more katamenoiko situation, for example, one more time, when we are right here, we will enter here, crossing completely, and we will have the following position. Remember that in katamenoiko, the weight waiting over the back, having control, because avoiding her in this case to go up and escape. From here, we could go for that it's also extension of the knee, but a more powerful control, it will be going to this side. It will be opening with a 90 degrees angle on the knee, and it's a very powerful, also we could get with a more powerful control here, that it's also permitted. And from here we have this control. This is one of the sequences that we could also apply, for example, if we deal with the katana, of course, we could pass with the handle, have control on the mouth, or near the nose, and it's very also powerful. Take a look that I will be pressing my handle here to avoid making the position, and from here, of course, I could pass the whole katana. It could be also a jaw, it could be whatever. And from here, we have this powerful lock here, making also being weight over herself. Also here, the pressure with the leverage that we have with the sole, it's also here, and here it's very powerful to pass on several positions and having the strong control, making the extension of the knee, or also making a torque on the knee. This is the first sequence explained on the kata regarding what is the onigumo on the ushiro side. If we pass for the following idea, we will go for other technique. Also, pressing, of course, we could strike, we could move to that way. And from here, what I will do is to pass this one here to have this control. And from here, I have this also powerful movement. Of course, we could go up and have this pressure here and having control on the other knee. We have the leg, and of course, we could move from a different position, having several controls to the other side. This is the second vision of the kata of ushiro. If we go to the mai, please, Rebecca-san, turn. We have face on, starting from, it doesn't matter because what we could do, whatever, it's several positions. We could start maybe from tachi position, and maybe, for example, we could apply the last techniques. For example, if we are on renkaku, and for example, I take a backward here, and when I enter and I go to the ground, I need only to have this control here, for from here having this powerful leverage here, or taking out and passing and having this powerful block here. Sorry, one more time. Only to show you, because Hakama is not helping me here. It's very powerful to have also control and applying the same ideas, the same leverage from a front position. But the main kata, the main sequence is playing on my, for example, from this circumstance, this situation, what I will do is I will strike, double strike on the face, near the eyes. And from here, I will take to the ground on this. I will have this control here, pass my hand to have here. And from here, of course, we have this control on the legs. And of course, this will pass to restrain stepping or kneeing on the medial side of the femoral area here. And we have this control, this powerful leverage. And if I turn, I will break the elbow here. The second sequence explained on this, of the many that has been explained on this course that I was explaining before, was the following. Also, the second double strike, having control on this one, having the control again, and for now, I will pass to the other side. The key here is that this pass over here now to control and breaking the knee here. This is the idea. If I turn, sorry, please beware, we have this powerful lock here to break, so we could tense on a different position. If we do from that point, I cross here, and when I knee down here, what I have is this powerful lock striking and breaking the knee with this kind of joint lock here. Of course, we could go and having very powerful strikes, trying to tear in the nose, the mouth, the ear. We have control, and of course, if we have hidden blades, we could enter to cut and pierce on different sides of the heel and the Achilles tendon here. And of course, several points on the face, and also the vital areas that we have on the neck. These are two ways to apply on this my situation. If we go for final, for example, turn 180 degrees. Thank you. For the yoko position, that it means the lateral position, the side position, what I will do is the following double strike. We have this control, and of course, we have this crossing my leg here, it's also a very powerful movement. Some of you could think that maybe she could try to take out maybe a small blade here and attacking my ankle. But the key here is to have this control to avoid her to react. But of course here, what we will do is to have the control on this situation, this position, because from here we have a very powerful lock, double lock. We have here the extension on the arm, the hyperextension on the elbow, and moreover that we have this bended knee here to have this powerful double lock here that we will break. The ankle is locked, the knee is completely locked and turning, but it's also very violent. From here, of course, we could break kneeing over after the knee is locked in order to destroy completely the distal areas of the crural area of the calf. Then this is one of the Yoko sequence explained. And the second one that we are explaining, only two of the main sequences of the kata, is the following thing here. We will again double strike. It's very important, the impact, to understand how to stop the any reaction, because of course she could draw any kind of sword, any kind of weapon that could be handling or hiding between her ropes or in the obi hand or carrying the obi. And double strike one more time. From here, what I will have is a double control on passing my hands through her armpits, like this position. When I turn, of course, I could pass to that side and I will have a very powerful control on the neck here. This could also break and having control on this side. From this position, of course, we could have this, and we could take this, or all from this, it's also very powerful if we have the control. But the most important or the main idea here is when we flow, we could pass this heel to open this leg, and from here to take it, the foot here, the left foot, and from here to make a powerful pulling movement here, a pulling motion, in order to trying to fall with my weight. At the same time, I am making a flexion on the arms, I am making a very strong traction in order to attack several points here. Moreover, the neck, we will have a bending movement on all the hips and the back. Then is the last technique for today. We have explained on the first, on the ushiro, in the backside, several conditioning, several ways to react, several ways to apply this concept on the main first kata. After that, we have explained another one in ushiro, and two on mai and two on yoko, on front side and the and aside. Then this is what is the onigumo explained on the basics, explained on this course hosted in 1992. I hope that you have enjoyed all this yabu line from our tradition. Thank you very much, and see you on next time.